Hello friends, welcome to Aviv Digital's daily live show. So hope you all are going good. So let's see who's getting in. So I have a link for you. Let's first drop that to you guys. So let's till then audience to build. So it's Aviv Digital. Thanks Vishnu, thanks Rajit. Great to see you all guys. So the link is ask.avivdigital.com. So that is our chat bot. So if you wanted to get notified whenever I go live, just go and I have just pinned it. So you can go and directly to that link and subscribe to list. So you will be getting notified before I go live. So the today's topic, what I am going to cover is how to make your video viral. So like as we all know that the coming market is going to be viral, going to be video marketing, because the content of video marketing is as day by day is going to increase only. Facebook is now neck to neck fighting with YouTube for on video creations and video channels. So if a normal video is having a follower around 1 lakh around followers, website is having Facebook account, a page is having in a video view around 1 lakh to 2 lakh million views, they are easily earning around 25 to 35,000 rupees per month based on the video views only. So their monetization policy only. So the video content is going to be big in the advertisement platform also and in the content populations also. So other like it's like kind of people we nowadays we don't like to read so much. We just wanted to get into some content, watch a small video and just go ahead with that. So that's what currently what we are looking for. So that's the topic. So let's see that how we can go and take our video to the viral stage, how we can make that video as a viral. So first thing, whenever you plan to go and create your content, make sure that the biggest platform you should always choose to go with your video. Like the biggest platforms are like Instagram, and if you are planning to go for live, Instagram, Facebook, and nowadays you can also go with other channels also where you will be target your live videos, like Periscope are there, which hosted by Twitter. So you can focus all those platforms, but you need to focus that your content should be available on the platform which is most famous, like YouTube. And so when you go and put your content syndication on these platforms, that going to give you an extra edge of getting viral of your videos. So that is the thing. Second thing, always that's the same reason why I choose Instagram to go live every day. And this is a live, so no cut, no edited video. It's going straight to you and you are just communicating. So that is like a fresh type of content. So the content which we make viral, so usually prepared in a like sort of spam, and we prepare that content, we prepare script, we prepared everything, then we make that video to publish on the YouTube channels and other platforms, and then do a basic advertisement on that. So to initial boost, if you guys are remember the egg history on Instagram, that campaign actually gone that much high because initial stage when that particular campaign started, some of the most influencer promoted that particular content. Then from once it's got promoted, then it's picked up and it's gone to the viral stage and one of the highest liked photo on Instagram history. So that way the initial stage boost is for any kind of video, any kind of content always required. So that's why we suggest to our client that if they are going and publishing a blog on your website, just take 40 rupees and put on Facebook and drive some right traffic towards that particular blog. We always suggest them to do that. So that is the part of advertising. Then the when videos, how you will be putting, whenever you are putting a video, you need to make sure that there should be some emotion triggering point. You should catch the exact pain point of the audience, and you can give some solution out of it, or you can give an exact things, what they can do, like step by step process, what they can do to and fix that particular problem, whatever they are facing it. So in that case, that's going to be like more shareable, more connected. They feel more one-to-one kind of video from video content from for that particular video. So that's the second thing. Then third thing, there should be uniqueness in your content. If your content is just going and copying from some other people, some other person has already done same video and you're just taking those videos and putting into the market, that's not going to be viral. So your video should have some uniqueness. And so how you find uniqueness, you create it, you can find it, you can get idea from different platform and change into that your platform or your market, how you can utilize in your market that particular idea. So always follow on that basis. So that is the thing, how you can take things ahead with the uniqueness section. So try to make your videos as a unique. Unique doesn't mean that you make so many like fictions or so many editings or so many extra activities on your video. The content should be unique and it should be passing some value to the audience, so that after listening, after giving whatever the time they are giving to you, after that they can feel that they can do something with that content. So that is the part of uniqueness what you need to focus on. Then fourth point is quality of the video. When you go with this platform, you should make sure it should not be like this live. So that should be in a good quality videos, because video quality is one of the most important aspect when it goes to the bigger audience. So people don't like to listen a video which is not having a good sound, which is not showing a good image, or which is not showing a good pictures, or it's not like appealing to the audience to watch for the end, till the end. So you need to make sure that you take help of editor, you take help of video editor who can do this kind of job. You don't have to focus on that, but you can make them to you can give them to do this kind of things, this editing part, and then put on the market. Also focus on the branding sections. You can just check out our channel, that is bit.ly /AvivDigitalYouTube. So you can go and check out our YouTube channel there, and you can see that whatever the video, this live video, when I'm republishing in our YouTube channel, I'm doing my basic branding section, what I'm right now not doing. So that's the difference when we take this content to the broader audience, broader segment. So initial it require in a small boost. Whenever you publish a content, go for a small boost. If you are putting on YouTube, go for the YouTube ad advertisement to drive some traffic towards that particular video. And it's not going to cost you so much. It's a very small, just start with the 100 rupees per day. It's enough for getting a good eye views to your content. So when you start getting eye views to your content, the possibility that your channel will get grow in a longer period. And the audience what coming in, they will be stable for the longer period. So that is the like point. And then after that, you need to make sure that you need to optimize your video with the right keywords. Like creating a video is a one part. When you optimizing that video, when you publishing that video, you need to make sure that that particular video is actually targeted to a particular audience, or it's reaching to the its end audience. So if you are publishing a content and you are writing it, giving a title, you are optimizing in the around a keyword which is not related to your audience, so your correct audience won't be going to see that video and your video is not going to be viral. So you need to make sure your title descriptions are very focused towards your audience, what they actually looking for and what kind of service you can offer to them. So you need to focus, you need to optimize title and description. When you go with the YouTube, try to focus, put your keyword. So what are the, your main keyword as early as possible. Also, usually when we do SEO, we try to focus the keywords for the long tail keywords to get ranked for. But when you go YouTube, the YouTube keyword research is completely different than SEO keywords. Never assume that the SEO keywords is the same for your YouTube channel. Go and get those keywords which is having high traffic. Maybe they are having high competition, that doesn't matter here. But you need to think about the keywords which is generally people will search for. Like just an example, if you are writing a, if you created a video on SEO tools, and if you're writing that in an article, SEO tools keyword will be very tough to rank. But in a video section, SEO tools benefits or SEO tools you can easily focus on, and you can work on your video, start building a links to your YouTube, that particular video, and start republishing that video to different channels, start embedding them video. The video actually, the video ranking, main ranking factor is your watch time. If you can able to increase your watch time of that particular video, your that video will increase ranking in the series. So that's the particular way you need to attract right audience to your video channel. So most of the time currently, the 70 to 80% traffic comes through featured posts. So the image what we use on top of the image, like we call it thumbnails. So we are using thumbnail, and these thumbnail are the one who attract the right audience. But you need to try to focus on having a right keyword and right descriptions on that particular video, so to attract a right kind of audience to your channel. And at the last point, what the main factor is, the content should be small and informative. It should not be like 1 hour long story and you're just talking and talking and talking and nobody is taking some actions. So the video should have any small content. It should for like, that's why I just started for 10 minutes video. I don't wanted to go for half an hour or 1 hour to talk about the same thing. I just wanted to finish the some special points, some section point in a particular manner. So that's the way how we plan for the content complete section. So it should be short, it should be informative, and it should be actionable, so they can go easily and do the actions. So like I just mentioned, like YouTube optimization process, you can go and put your keywords in front of that, you can put description with the keywords, you can use tags with the right keywords, you can upload your video when with the name of the keywords on your MP4 file or MPV file, so whatever the file you are uploading into YouTube. So these are the some basic things you need to focus on before uploading your YouTube video to your YouTube channel. So that is a small tip and informative content just wanted to pass on. So that's it for today's session. Hope you guys find some value here, and if you have any question, make feel free to ask here, or you can go to ask.avivdigital.com. That is our chat bot, and you will get subscribed to our Facebook channel, and you will be get notified whenever we are going live, and you will be able to acquire this information towards you. And if you have any question, make feel free to just leave a below. And let me thanks everyone to getting in. Thanks everyone who has got in. Adinan, Jansil, Arjun, Astar, Vishnu, Munil, that's Vishnu, Mohammad Niyas, Abhiram, everyone, thanks guys, thanks for getting in. Hope I am passing some value to you guys, and this is our daily series. We are going live on 7 p.m. Monday to Friday, so hope you are enjoying these sessions and is passing some value to you guys. So that's it in these sessions. If you guys are having any question, you can just drop below, or let me go ahead with. So I'm just waiting for questions. If you guys are having some, is there any limit for description while uploading video in YouTube? So make sure at least minimum 300 words should be in your description, and that should be keyword. This is not SEO. You don't bother that Google will going to penalize you for that, but you can make this content with the keywords, and little bit more keyword will be there. It's fine for them to not any issue with that. So you can easily optimize that way. Description should be with keywords, and try to focus whatever the title you have given and include in the your description also. And never forget to get a link back to your website from your YouTube description. That's the one place you can get your YouTube video links to your particular websites also. That's a backlink for you, so YouTube backlinks. So that's the thing, you can do that, like meta description SEO. Yeah, just I think I have explained the question correctly. Like you can go more, you should keep at least minimum 300 words, because if you are able to give in a caption of that particular content, is that's also good. And you can put more content. And what about the tags? Tags are the limited number, so it's based on the character, how many characters you are using in a tag. So you can use up to 14 to 15 tags easily over there with the keywords, and try to focus on the tags which are very much near to your audience, and also it's not like dead in the future, like SEO training 2019, which don't work in 2020, because your video will be there. for the 2020 and 2020-21. So you need to focus on the tax which is going to be universal. So like SEO titles, SEO tags. So these are the tags you should use, not the year based. So I have seen like so many videos are there who just use the tags for the year. So they are just killing their videos live by using those kind of tags. So you can use say up to 15 tags based on the character in a tag, you how much tag, how much lengthy tags you are using. And before using tag, go to keyword research, and you can use keyword everywhere, and that give very good that's in a you can use extension, Chrome extensions, keyword everywhere. That's actually take data from keyword planner itself, but you can use, you can find the some keywords which you can use in a tag. And the best part, whatever video you going to optimize on YouTube, first go and search in YouTube what is the keyword you going behind, and see that who are coming on top 10 result at least, and go and take all the tags what they have quoted, and you see that what are the highest relevant tags for you, and take that to keyword planner and check the traffic, what traffic are particular keywords, and then make decision which 15 keywords or which 15 to 16 keywords you are going to use in your video tags. So that's the tags process. Hope I have answered that question too. So let me know if you have any more questions to take on, or just say bye and it should be. And thanks guys getting in, and make sure if you are enjoy this video, make sure to share with your friend. If you have any question, just reach out to us. And if you wanted some specific topic to get covered, just go to bit.ly/AvivDigitalLive. So that is a form, Google form. You just fill out your question. I will take that question to there. So now next question from Vishnu is, after uploading a video, is there any option to edit and re-upload? There is no option. So that's why once the video is uploaded over there, you can only edit on the content and title part. That's why we say that whenever you upload a video, you already file name of that video with the keywords, like that keyword part will be already included in your content. So that's it. I think I have just passed some of questions. Like if you are having, you can just reach out to the process, go to ask.avivdigital.com, get subscribe, get notified when we go live. And next is, if you have any question, just go to bit.ly/AvivDigitalLive and leave your question. And thanks guys, thanks for watching in. Let's wind up for the today. Thanks to see you guys, and great day, have a nice day, and take care, bye bye. And let me see if I can come live tomorrow. I'm actually traveling. If possible, I will come, and I will let you know guys before I'm coming live to mini chat. So thanks guys. So how to create more traffic to your video? Okay Adnan, so traffic comes when your videos get ranked, and I just mentioned that traffic not comes only through your keywords, it also comes as in a supportive videos, or like when it comes to other video selection, like when we are playing a video, we are seeing the other suggested video. So most of the traffic of YouTube channel comes through suggested videos. So work on your thumbnail should not be so much clickbait. Clickbait means like you may have seen the some of the thumbnail where they are showing a big snake and attacking to someone. When you watch that video, there is a small snake. So that kind of over optimized clickbait images, your thumbnails you should not use. So that is one suggested video. Then this suggested video optimized based on the keywords, tags you use in your video, also the watch time, how many people are sticking to your video. And YouTube wants very simple thing, YouTube wants people to stick with YouTube. If a person getting into YouTube, they stick at least for the some certain of time. That the more you make people to stick with your video, the optimization and the traffic to that particular video getting high and high. And try to make get people to subscribe to your channel, engage to you, comment you, give a thumbs up. These are the some engagement actions which they prefer. Like if video is good, people will be giving them thumbs up. If channel is good, people be subscribing to them. So these are the some basic things you require to show that YouTube that your channel is worth out. And the biggest thing is like keep on updating videos, keep on putting content. You can't build a you can't build in a day your channel. You have to work on for a longer period. No one has built their YouTube channel in one day. So you need to work on, keep on updating content over there for a long time. So I think I just answered all the questions. I am not seeing any more questions here. So thanks guys, thanks for watching in, getting in, and that's what gives great pleasure to have you all. And thanks, I got my answer. Thank you. So let's wind up.